bring it back inside the rink here, the studio, because our two guys, Mike Johnson, Mark Parrish, they're going to redraft it. And I just want you to first look at the notes. Look at the notepad for Mark and then the notes for Johnny. Mark, you're taking this very seriously.
Clearly, preparation, Nelly, was on Mark's side because he was ready to go to work. Last time he did this, he was going up against Brian Lawton, a former GM. Now he's going up against me, a wannabe, never GM. So we'll see how we do. I like your chances this time through.
I got taken to school on Monday. Anybody who was watching knows. I'm ready today.
Okay, I better be on point then. No pun intended. I'm not on point. I'm going to go with my first overall pick as we go through the 2014 draft once again. I am taking Leon Draisaitl, who was taken third overall by the Edmonton Oilers initially. I think the combination of size, speed, skill, and the fact that he plays center is why I took him first overall. He's proven himself to be a consistent offensive performer. He's my number one.
Well, I'm going to go back to being on point. My number one pick, Braden Point. Oh. And on a personal note, 79th, third round, that's what I was, 79th.
79th, exactly.
I'm not saying I meant should have been number one, but that's, it just hit home. Braden Point, he has just stepped up incredibly. He has gotten better and better last few years. He's on pace for 108, on pace for 108 points right now, and he has stepped up with a very strong Tampa Bay Lightning lineup,
yeah.
And he has taken advantage of it.
He's an incredible player. That's why I have him at 12 as well. And for a guy that was taken in the third round because they thought he might be too small, we know now in the NHL, too small doesn't matter. He showed himself to be a good shutdown defender. John Cooper calls him the next Patrice Bergeron. That's how good this guy is. So 79 must be a good draft pick. If I'm taking 79 next year, I'm liking my chances.
Absolutely. And I, of course, went with Leon Draisaitl.
Okay.
Agreed. Centerman, I put a lot of weight on centerman. They've got to play both ends. They can't be half-court style players. Yeah, you could say a little bit because of Connor McDavid here and there, yeah. Might be, you know, that helped him out a little bit. That being said, he had a very strong playoffs a couple
great
years ago.
Great in the playoffs, that's
great
right.
Great playoffs, and that's why he's my number two.
All right, I'm going to the leading goal scorer now from that draft class for night number three. Proud to select David Pastrnak. This guy was taken 25th overall by the Boston Bruins. There is no purer finisher available from this draft class than David Pastrnak. He stepped in and plays with great players in defensively responsible positions with Bergeron and Marchand, and he has been spectacular throughout. So third, Pastrnak, he was drafted way too low a few years ago.
Were you looking at my notes?
No.
Because that's kind of verbatim, okay. Pretty much what I had right here. I agree. He's the number one goal scorer in this draft. He has stepped up. He's got better and better and better. He is on pace for 46 goals this year.
Yeah, he is. And highlight reel. He is a highlight machine. So David Pastrnak, number four for me, the most important position up front is center. So I take Dylan Larkin. I was taken by the Detroit Red Wings at 15. He has actually grown in his offensive game these past couple of years more than I thought he would. With the absence of Datsyuk, the absence of Zetterberg, he's shown himself to be a leader and a guy that can play both ends of the ice and have another great offensive season. Fourth overall, Dylan Larkin.
We're agreeing again. What's going on here?
I'm not liking my chances.
What are we doing here? All right, we got Dylan Larkin. I agree. And not only has his offense picked up, but I think his responsibilities in his own end have picked up, is what you want to see as the centerman gets older, because he has no choice but to get better defensively. So I am with you on Dylan Larkin.
All right, number six, I am going to Slick Nick Ehlers, one of my favorite players in the NHL. I realize he's not a perfect player, but he has money offensively. He will produce. He'll get you 25 to 30 goals. He'll get you 60 to 70 points, and he will do it for a decade. He's got speed and skill, and that's what the offensive game is all about in today's NHL.
And finally, we disagree a little bit. I went back with Aaron Ekblad. Defenseman, they're the most important. Well, but besides goaltender, goaltender, defenseman, center, you went up the middle, starting from the back end. Aaron Ekblad, yeah, his numbers have dipped just a little bit, but that's because he's got a lot more responsibility in the D zone, not just getting offensive zone faceoffs. He'll come back around offensively.
I can't crush it too much because I have him at six as well, Aaron Ekblad. Trajectory is a bit of an issue. He won Rookie of the Year. You thought, here he comes. This guy's going to be a stud, one of a Norris Trophy candidate for the next decade. He's not quite at that level, but I love the fact that he can score goals from the defensive position. I got him at six. He was first overall for Florida.
Absolutely. Now, here we're going to differ a little bit. Victor Arvidsson. I have got myself just a little bit of a man crush on this guy. We talked about him last night. The way he plays his complete game, he's just kind of sitting around that 60-point, 30-some goals. I love the way he plays his complete game. He plays big minutes. He plays in any situation. He's my number six.
All right. I got him at seven. Victor Arvidsson, for all the things he does, every situation, shorthanded, power play. He's been through the playoffs with the grind. Nashville showed how much they missed him this year when he wasn't around. I got him at seven.
And now I'm going to go back up to your number five, Nicholas Ehlers. Okay. I love the way he has stepped in Winnipeg, a tough lineup to crack, and he has stepped in there, and he has become a go-to player up there. I love the way he's about 60-ish points a year. He keeps climbing. I love the way he plays.
Sneaky, good offensive player, Sam Reinhart. Taken second overall and maybe not turned into a dominant forward, but he puts up 50 or 60 or more this year. He's played not just with Jack Eichel. I like him. He's going to be a good offensive player for a long time.
Now, this one, I can't wait to hear what you have to say about Kasperi Kapanen in Toronto. He has shown, I know he's only got a few games, a little smaller sample size, but boy, did he step in and play for William Nylander while he was out and showed. I cannot wait to see what he has left in his career.
Your scouts are going to be on the hot seat in 2 years. I took William Nylander, who was taken eighth overall. I took him at ninth. I know he's not playing that great right now production-wise, but he's been really good, talented offensive player everywhere he's gone. He's been great. He's my number nine.
Alex Tuch.
Yeah.
Love Alex Tuch. He's young. Boy, I tell you what, the way he played in the playoffs last year, he deserves to be in that top 10.
I got him at 10. Alex Tuch, you're going down the road 18. I didn't even know he was drafted this year, and yet I have him in my top 10, and he's only going to get better.
And then now I got your number 8, Sam Reinhart.
All right.
Boy, I love the way this kid plays, and I'm looking forward to seeing what he adds offensively and as a complete game in the future.